Hello again, everybody. Welcome to Operation Football. I'm Andy Kendi. Always a good and fun opening round of the playoffs. Couple of major upsets as we're getting video into the station really late. We'll start with Papillion La Vista and Bellevue West. This is Bellevue West. This is Luke Johansson. The pretty catch to Kyrell Jordan. It's 21-7 Bellevue West. Next possession, LJ Richardson running right into your living room. T-Birds flying high. They eliminate Papio 63-26. All right. How about Omaha Burke? They're back in the playoffs after OPS canceled the fall sports season last fall, hosting Lincoln Southeast. Bulldogs down 3-0 in the second, not anymore. Donovan Moody, a couple of moves, finds the end zone on the 15-yard run, 7-3. Then 3 minutes before halftime, Burke stretches their lead to double digits. 4th and 6, Cooper Katsky drops the dime to Trey Starks. That was nice. 23-yard touchdown, 14-3 game at the half. Bulldogs then put the dagger in the night season in the fourth. Katsky to Titan Klassman, 10-yard touch. Burke advances. They win 21-3. Your final.
I felt amazing. That was the best game I've played in years. It just felt amazing. The team felt amazing. Not having a season last year and everything, it was great.
Burke now 8-2. They'll play the winner of Papio South, second-seeded Westside. The Warriors defending state champs, making it look easy. Anthony Rizak connecting with Grant Goyette. 28-0 at the half, and it's really all Westside in this one. Colby Brown back in at quarterback. Goyette again with the score. Warriors win big. 39-0. All right, here's your bracket. We're going to give a couple things away here, but Bellevue West will take on Grand Island, and Omaha Burke will take on Westside. All right, number one seed, Millard South. Here's what people are talking about tonight. They're taking on Omaha North over at Buell. Patriot quarterback and Husker commit Gage Stanger. He's been injured lately, though. He's back, and look at this place. Scramble finds Antrell Taylor for the 59-yard strike, and Millard South up 7-0 early. North, though, not fazed. Jordan Williams, the play-action fake, and he wants it, and he wants it all. Finds Travion Brown, 73 yards. The Vikings not going away. They tied this bad boy. Stanger responds from Millard South. Looks for Jake Gassaway. A little bobble, but the refs allow a 22-yard score. And Omaha North, though, in a wild game, gets a late score and wins 49-42. 16 beats 1. Wow. Gretna looking for their first playoff win as a member of Class A. Opening drive, Noah Burhop getting the target on the slant. Knights go up 7-0. Eastwood add another score before Braden Cheney turns on the Jets. The senior goes 100 yards on the kick return. Are you kidding me? Dragons get on the board. Fun one tonight in Gretna. Hope you had the over. Zane Flores sneaks one in to tie the game 14-all. And then in the second quarter, same score, Noah Walters finds Malachi Coleman on the back shoulder. Hearing a lot about this kid. And it's good to be 6'5", right? Great athleticism. Dragons win a shootout, 59-42. Late game in Elkhorn. Elkhorn South trying to beat Kearney for the second time this season. Storm down 7-0, but score back-to-back touchdowns. This is the second of the two. Will Scratus finds Chase Anderson, and Elkhorn South leads 13-7. Then just before half, it's Scratus to Carson Crouch. Yeah, Eric's son for the touchdown. He can play too. Storm up 21-13, and they win 35-20, your final. So here's the other side of Class A. Omaha North will take on North Platte, and then Gretna will take on Elkhorn South. I guess Elkhorn South does not have their logo in the second round, but we'll get it there, absolutely. Okay, let's go back to Creighton Prep and Grand Island. As we said, a couple of huge, huge upsets. We saw Millard South go down, and how about Creighton Prep? How did they do? Well, let's join Matt Foster, who's standing by live over at Burke Stadium. Hey, Matt.
Hey, Andy, as we've seen tonight, anything can happen in the playoffs, and apparently seeding means nothing. Just ask Grand Island, the Islanders, the 11 seed, traveling to Creighton Prep at Burke Stadium. GI up 10-0 in the second when Prep finally gets on the board. Jack Stessman will not be denied. He powers his way in from 9 yards out, making it a 10-6 game. Next prep possession, give it to Stessman again, and he'll make the magic happen. 42 yards to the end zone, because he's got reservations for six, 13-10 Jays. Islanders retake the lead right before the half. Kuyten Fyfe buying time, rolling right, and he's going to find a wide open Cole Thorne. 17-13 Islanders on the break. Upset alert. GI stretch their lead to 24-13 in the third until Prep counters with Stessman again, this time from 37. Four touchdowns on the night from him. 24-21 game. But Kuyten Fyfe delivers the dagger late in the fourth on third and goal from the 15. Rolling right again, buying time, and he hits Thorne in the end zone for six. And Grand Island pulls off the upset at Burke Stadium, 30-28. You know, heading into this night, the way things are going, I thought this would be the upset of the night. Apparently not. But Grand Island with a much tougher task next week. They'll get Bellevue West in the quarterfinals. Reporting live at Burke Stadium, Matt Foster, KETV News Watch 7 Sports.
All right, thank you, Matt. Halftime here on Op Football. Up next, the Class B story and beyond. But first, sending us to break, the West Side Spirit Squad.